Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's an audio generator. Sine wave and square wave. And it's a tech model TE-22. The fun thing about this unit is it looks very much like Heat Kit. Even the buttons and the banana plugs, everything here is just so much like a Heat Kit. So I can't wait until we have a look inside. I think everything here is just a Heat Kit copy. There's a thing that is a little bit funny here. Frequency in cycles per second. Since when is frequency not cycles per second? Or have you ever heard about frequency not being cycles per second? My God, why are you writing this? That is funny. So the dial is geared, so that's great. The problem is this scale kind of go down when you dial that way, right? And the other scale go the other way when you go that way, right? Then it goes down. Isn't that a little bit weird? And then what? How can you know 110, 100 times 1000, right? So this is just a multiplier, but it does not say which one of the scales are we looking at? What? So this could be 20 hertz. This could be 20 hertz. How can I know? Oh, so now it's 200 hertz here or 200 hertz here. I don't know. No clue. That is so stupid. So... I mean, even this just so much looked like a Heat Kit. Not exactly that one. Ooh. And what have we got here? We got all the photocopies from Radiomuseum. Thank you very much. It tells us everything we need to know. Ooh, look at that. Only three tubes. And it's from 1965 to 1972. Japan. Okay. Oh, this one is in German. That is funny. All right, so I better just fire it up and see if it takes the fuses. How about that? Yips. Let's do that. Let's just power this thing up. So that is mains applied. 27, 20, 17, 15 watts. So this is like a normal tube warm-up. I see a little... Oh, look at that! What is that? What are we looking at? Yay! No. Okay. That is okay, 62 hertz. And it is still in a really weird warm-up. Let's crank up the juice. Oh, yeah. I don't know if you can see this, but there is a weird amplitude modulation on the signal. Oh, yeah. That is mains frequency ripple. Or no, this is too low to be that, isn't it? So that is 60. Oh. Let's see if the frequency goes up. Yes, it does indeed. So that will be probably be 200. Yes, what? That is accurate. Look at that. Okay, so the first uses the first scale. Okay, let's go for the next one. Let's start with... Okay, so that is 2 kilohertz. That is also what I expect, right? Times 10 and 200. Okay, so is it going? Yes, it is. Let's try here. 400 and... Oh, I am a little bit impressed. What do you know? Okay, so let's go here. So that will be 200 hertz again, and it's super accurate. So that will be 2 kilohertz. Still. And then it goes up again. Okay. To 20 kilohertz. Okay, let's guess what we got here. 200 kilohertz. And it's again. I mean, look at that. How can it be this accurate? This thing is old. Okay, and then it's 20 kilohertz, spot on. So that means frequency is that one. So what is this other dial doing? No clue whatsoever. From 0 to 100 bananas. This is not in use. And what about... Okay. Huh. Well, it is a square wave, sort of. Okay, I'm running in quite fast. Let's go down. Okay, so the rise time is... Look at that. Is exactly the same. And that is not a big surprise, is it? And then we just crank down the frequency. So that is 6 kilohertz. Yeah, so... Oh... Not exactly 50% or anything, but this machine is working as far as I am concerned. We got variable output power, frequency here, la 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 la. It's working, and it's, I mean, yeah, okay, maybe it needs new capacitors to make this super stable, or look what happened now. After a little bit of warm-up, now it's super stable. What if I go... No! It has something to do with the frequency. Now this is slow. Let's go to 50 hertz. And see if that is not the worst possible. Or is it probably the best possible frequency you could select? Look how stable it is now. And that is at 50 hertz. What if I choose 40 hertz? Can you see the problem? I don't know. Is it easy to see? But then you see, of course, the problem, right? This is mains frequency modulation on the output. But at exactly 50 hertz, it just becomes zero or close to zero. Ha ha. And this is 100 hertz, yeah, yeah. Yes, this is very funny. So yes, this definitely looks a lot like HeatKit products. We only got 3 tubes, so that's all there is in this thing. Oh, look at that. The transformer is really bent. So I guess this one was dropped on the floor. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, definitely, look at that. Oh. Yeah, this was dropped. So this entire metal here is bent. Oh, let's see if we can fix that. And it hit, oh, look at that. Didn't damage the tube, but the tube is all bent in the socket. I don't know if you can see this. And so this holder clip is touching the transformer. Oh yeah, that is the flexible coupling and the, oh, I need to be careful where I stick my fingers. So that is the gear coupling. Oh, this is classic. The American and the European tube numbering. This looks like a diode or a something like that, right? So yeah, that's kind of what there is to it. Let's have a look here in the bottom. Some resistors, capacitors, and that's kind of what there is. Yeah, look at this, a little fine trimmer capacitor, I guess that is. What have we got right here? Tiny little diode? Or maybe this is a filament bulb compensation for sine wave, because this is connected to the oscillator. Could be. It's just a really weird casing. But see, there's no pin 1, pin 2, or no pin identification. So that is my best guess. Uh-huh. That one. That capacitor here is a 3-in-1 capacitor. That one is what I would change the first. Because they always have the shortest lifetime, those 2 or 3-in-1. Oh, also look at that one. This is also a high voltage capacitor right next to a hot power resistor. You can even see there's a little bit of brown on the capacitor. So this can't be good for its lifetime. Yeah, but other than that, it looks quite all right. The on bulb is a little bit weird. What have they done here? So there's a, how many wires? Uh-huh, so that will be wires for the what? So that bulb is connected to most likely filament voltage or some stuff. I'm not sure I understand exactly what that is. What is the idea? And there's a wide. Okay, this is the on. It goes to this kind of. I don't know. But I think I don't want to play anymore with this one. Ooh, 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 ooh. This we need to fix. Oh, this is completely loose. This one is okay. Anything else that's like loosey juicy? Okay, I better fix this. And then I will mount it all again.